Good morning, my dear students. Last class have completed some part of the pharmacognosy, antidiuretic drugs and acidosis drugs and pharmaceutical aids. So these all we completed previous class, and today class we'll discuss about the miscellaneous drugs. So under miscellaneous drugs, so we have many drugs in that category. So let us start with the licorice. Licorice is other name is glycyrrhiza or licorice root. It is one of the glycoside containing drug which is having a very sweet in taste. So generally, so the drugs are having a bitter taste, bitter in taste, sour taste, pungent taste, like. But this is the only drug having a sweet in taste, and also we have other drugs like honey, and this is a root containing drug having sweet in taste. So licorice, other name is glycyrrhiza. It is a dried roots and stolons obtained from the glycyrrhiza glabra, and belongs to family leguminosae family. So this drug is cultivated in Russia, Spain, and Persian countries. So there are different varieties of licorice. So source will be same, but variety is different. So one is glycyrrhiza glabra variety, typica, that is Spanish licorice cultivated in Spain, and second one is glycyrrhiza glabra variety, glandulifera. It is Russian licorice. They are cultivating in Russia. And third one is glycyrrhiza glabra variety, Violacea. So it is from the Persian countries, called as Persian licorice. So licorice is one of the root containing drug. We want only roots from the licorice. So the roots are the cylindrical appearance, and they are straight, and they are again two types, peeled and unpeeled. So like orange is there, orange. So orange will see the peeled one and unpeeled one. So peeled, unpeeled. Peeled is orange color, unpeeled is light yellowish color. So like that here. So licorice also having peeled and unpeeled. Peeled root is having yellowish browning color, and whereas peeled one is yellowish color, unpeeled one is yellowish browning color. So they are cylindrical appearance, and they are straight, and stolons and roots, and stolons are having the apical buds and scars and striations you can see in the stolons, and their size is around 20 to 50 centimeters length and 2 centimeters diameter. So you can see it's very bigger in size, and odor is faint and characteristic. So taste is very sweet in taste. So next, coming to the chemical constituents. So licorice contains the saponin glycosides. Under saponin glycosides, so we have the tri-terpenoid glycosides. So 5 to 7% glycyrrhizin is the main constituent. The sweet principle is called as glycyrrhizin. It is a potassium and calcium salts of glycyrrhizic acid. So licorice also contains glucose, sucrose, starch, and some calcium oxide crystals also present in licorice. Glycyrrhizinic acid is a glycoside. On hydrolysis, we'll be getting the glycyrrhizinic acid. Glycyrrhizinic acid and glycyrrhetic acid. And also they have the carbenoserone. So coming to the chemical test, on treatment with sulfuric acid, the section of the drug is going to give the deep yellowish color, and also answers the saponin glycoside test. Saponins are nothing but the soap-like formation with water. So you can add, you can take small quantity of drug and you can add water for that, and you'll be getting some foam formation or soap formation because of they are the saponin and glycosides. And coming to the uses, so licorice, as I told, one of the sweetening agent, and also we can use as a demulcent and expectorant, and treatment of gastric disorders. Also we'll be using as a ulcer, gastric ulcers, we'll be using this licorice. So because this drug contains other glycosides like flavonoids, like liquidin, isoliquidin, also quetiapine, liquorice. So that is nothing but the peptic ulcer treatment. So because of due to the isoliquidin present in the liquorice, so showing peptic ulcer treatment. Also, it is used as a diuretic and laxative, and also mineralocorticoid activity. So also treatment of the rheumatoid arthritis, inflammation, like anti-inflammatory. So as a flowering agent, moreover, this drug is using as a flowering agent, chewing tobacco and snuff tobacco is one of the ingredient. So making cigarettes and all, no? So they'll be using this liquorice as a flowering agent. And also in beverages and confectionaries and as a pharmaceutical aid. So coming to the substitutes and adulterants. So one is Manchurian liquorice is one of the substitute of the glyceriza. That name is glyceriza urolensis is substitute of the liquorice. So there are many preparations from the liquorice. So liquorice powder available, liquorice compound powder available, liquorice liquid extract available. So glyceriza fluid extract available, lozenges is available. They'll be using as a pharmaceutical aid. Next drug is second drug is garlic. So garlic is a very important drug. We'll be knowing about garlic in Canada. We'll be calling as a bilulli. So garlic is a dried bulb containing drug. So bulbs are available, looks like onion. So these bulbs are yellowish color and the bulbs are having scale leaves, and we can separate the scale leaves into small pieces or scale leaves, and they are yellowish in color. So source is a dried bulb obtained from the Allium sativum, Liliaceae family. So it is available in India and other countries like Sri Lanka and all. So garlic is a yellowish white in color, bulb is yellowish white in color, odor is a faint and characteristic odor, and taste is acrid and bitter in taste. And sizes are the around 5 to 10 centimeters diameter. These bulbs having many scale leaves in that. And taste is acrid and bitter taste. So coming to chemical constituents, it is one of the drug having the sulfur containing compounds. So because garlic is having sulfur containing compounds, also they have some essential ions or volatile ions. So main constituents are the allyl propyl disulfide, dialyl disulfide, dimethyl allyl cysteine sulfoxide, and disulfides, polysulfides. They are all the sulfur containing compounds present in the garlic. Garlic also contains allene, allicin, and dialyl sulfide. Also having the allostatin 1 and 2, and satavins, and anthocyanins, carbohydrates, proteins, amino acids, glycosides like kemferol, quercetin. Also having saponin glycosides, beta cetosterol, cholesterol. Also they have some vitamins and polysaccharides. Also having steroidal saponins, herbicide B, isoherbicide B, vitamin A, B, C, and vitamin E. So vitamin E is one of the main vitamin present in the garlic. So garlic actually one of the antimicrobial and antibacterial agent. So during Second World War, so those days there were no antibiotics. So those days I think they were not discovered the antibiotics. So those days, so during World War time, so they will be using this garlic directly to the wound affected area in the body. So they'll be applying directly this garlic pieces into that particular part of the body, and it reduces the swelling and it reduces the inflammation in the body. So because of the wound healing activity is there for this drug, also acting as antimicrobial, antibacterial, and antifungal agent, antiseptic, mainly antiseptic. So those days, no antibiotics. In place of antibiotics, people were using directly applying garlic bulbs for the wound healing activity. Also, this drug is useful for the nose, throat, and chest. Mainly, this drug is reduces the cholesterol levels in the body, helps the circulatory disorders for high blood pressure, and lowers blood sugar levels. We'll be using this garlic. That's why you see elder people in the house, no, they'll be taking directly garlic raw pieces and they'll be eating directly garlic raw pieces. So that here what happens, they reduce the cholesterol levels in the body. Also, it brings normal blood pressure. So that's why they'll be using this garlic. So garlic also having significant action against heart disease, what I told, strokes, and serum levels can be reduced. And also, they'll be using as a in the treatment of diabetes and rheumatism, blood pressure, intestinal disorders, stimulant, carminative, anthelmintic, hypoglycemic agent, diuretic, aprodisiac. Means, no, the drugs which increase sexual desire is called as aprodisiac. So they'll be using this drug as a hypotensive, anti-inflammatory, antimicrobial, antifungal, for leprosy, cough repressions, piles, and painful menstruation. It also gives for asthma and whooping cough. So garlic is having many remedies. So mainly, we can also use this drug as antioxidant. So antioxidants means the drugs which scavenge the free radical formation in the body. So in our body, so there are many free radical formations. We have to scavenge or we have to prevent this free radicals in the body. Otherwise, it leads to the dreadful diseases like the maybe like hypertension, maybe diabetes, or maybe cancer. So we have to scavenge or we have to prevent these free radicals which are circulating in the body in the form of ROS. ROS is nothing but the reactive oxygen species in the body. So they are circulating the body. So along with these electrons of the other molecules of the body, they tend to react with the electrons of other molecules in the body, and they give the lipid peroxidation or the lipid oxidation and lipid peroxidation. And what happens here, cellular damage takes place, DNA damage takes place. Due to DNA damage, so leads to the maybe hypertension or maybe cancer, maybe like diabetes or maybe many other diseases. That's the main use of the garlic, is antioxidant. So vitamin E is responsible for the antioxidant activity in the garlic. So next, another drug is so we have the linseed. Linseed is one of the important drug. It is a carbohydrate containing drug. So linseed is a carbohydrate containing drug. So linseed is other name is flax seed, and the seeds are very small in size. So like isabgol, we have discussed already. So like isabgol, this linseed also having very small in size, and source is dried seeds obtained from the Linum usitatissima, and family is Linaceae family, and it is available in cultivated in India and other countries, USA, Canada, and even Russia. And the seeds are very small in size, and so they have brown in color. And water is waterless, and taste is mucilaginous, like isabgol. Linseed is having mucilaginous taste, bland taste. Seeds are very small in size, what I told, 4 to 6 mm in length, 2 to 2.5 mm width. So whereas, if you compare to isabgol is having 1 to 1.5 mm length, but this one is 4 to 6 mm, still little bigger in size, this linseed. So they are elongated and ovate shape, and flattened in one side, rounded at the other side, and so they have the glossy appearance, and they have a hilum, because since seeds are having hilum, seeds will be having hilum and raphe, and we have the cotyledons or chalaza, and they are glossy appearance, the seeds. And coming to the chemical constituents, linseed contains the mainly carbohydrates. So carbohydrates contains again fixed oil, carbohydrates contains mucilage. So mucilage present in the linseed. So isabgol is having mucilage, and here also having mucilage, and other constituents like fixed oils also present in the linseed. So they are 30 to 40% of fixed oils present, proteins present 25%, mucilage 6%. Also they have some glycosides. So glycosides are the cyanogenic glycoside present in the linseed. So main constituent is here linamarin from the cyanogenic glycoside. It is so useful as a demulcent, and also crushed seeds, no, useful as a poultice, and linseed oil is useful as a preparation of liniments and paints. They'll be using this linseed oil, and also linseed cake is a valuable cattle feed. Also linseed, no, they'll be using as a the preparation of the paints and varnishes. if you want to prepare the paints and varnishes, we can use this linseed. One of the active constituents is this linseed is having mucilage, so that is having a drying oils. Linseed is a drying oil, so it is responsible for the, so useful in the preparation of paints and varnishes. So next one is picrorhiza. It is also one of the very important drug. Picrorhiza is other name is kutiki or Indian gentian, and it is the dried rhizomes and roots obtained from the rhizomes and roots. Rhizomes obtained from the picrorhiza coraya. Picrorhiza coraya and belongs to family Scrofulaceae family. So we have already discussed earlier one drug that name is digitalis. So digitalis also having the Scrofulaceae family. So this drug also belongs to Scrofulaceae family. So dried rhizomes obtained from the Picrorhiza coraya and the family Scrofulaceae. It is cultivated in India and China. See India near Himalayas, near Himalaya region, and Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, they'll be cultivating this Picrorhiza, one of the rhizome containing drug. And the rhizomes are the around 3 to 5 centimeters in length rhizomes. They are cylindrical appearance and they have a scars. Stems are having root scars and having some striations in the roots and rhizomes, having wrinkles in the rhizomes, and the color will be a deep grayish brown in color, and they have a slight and unpleasant odor. So taste is very bitter in taste, and size is 3 to 5 centimeters in length and 0.5 to 1 centimeter in diameter, and appearance is cylindrical appearance, conical. They have a buds and stems having the some wrinkles, and contains mainly so iridide bitter compounds present in the drug. So one of the bitter containing drug, bitter tonic, a bitter drug having bitter principles, so called as iridides. So iridides contains picrocide 1 and picrocide 2 and cuticoside. Cuticoside, picrocide 1 and 2 also having the cutkin and corticosterol, cutkin, vanillic acid, mannitol, and apocynin, cuticoside, and phenolic glycoside also present in the picrorhiza. Also having the some cucurbitacin glycosides. So cucurbitacin glycosides are having the this cucumber. So cucumber is having a cucurbitacin glycosides, and here this glycoside is present in this drug also, picrorhiza. So uses, as I told already, bitter tonic. So because bitter in taste, so this acted as a bitter tonic, this drug. So since bitter tonic means, so these drugs, no, they can use as reducing fever. So and also increase the appetite. Generally all the bitter tonics will be using as increasing appetite, nothing but the hungerness. So for hunger is increasing hungerness, we'll be using these drugs in the form of tonic. Also, these drugs reduces fever and for stomach irritations and cathartic, so dyspepsia and as laxative. So it also use the anti-periodic drug, cholagogue and fever, anti-malarial. For jaundice, they'll be using this drug. It is one of the important drug for the treatment of jaundice or liver disorders. We'll be using this drug and also removes kidney stones in, and also as immunogogue and emetic. So already earlier we have discussed one drug, Epicoc. Epicoc also having emetic property. The drugs which induce vomiting sensation is called as emetic. This drug also useful as emetic and antidote for drug bite, and also using for skin diseases, and also having for eyesight, they'll be using this drug. So next, another drug is so Diascoria. It is also one of the very important drug. So Diascoria is again belongs to saponin glycosides. Saponin glycosides having Diascoria and licorice. So Diascoria is one of the dried tuberous roots. So dried tuberous roots obtained from the Diascoria deltoidea, Diascoria compositae, and Diascoria floribunda. So family Diascoriaceae family or compositae family, and they'll be cultivated in India and also USA and Mexico. Mexico, USA, and India. they will be cultivating. This is one of the climber drug. This is diaspora, one of the climber drug. So looks like pepper plant, looks like betel leaf plant, and as one of climber, this drug BSC leaves. The leaves are in alternate side. So leaves are having a heart shape. Looks like heart shape. Leaves are having a heart shape. And we require here rhizomes, color will be slight browning color, and water waterless, taste bitter in taste. Sizes various depending on the rhizomes. Some will be small in size, some will be bigger in size. And they are very soft in nature, and not like hard, because rhizomes are soft compared to other drugs. They are softer. So this diasporia rhizomes are having the epidermis they have in the drug. Also having cork and cortex will be there. So parenchymal cells are present in the diasporia TS. And vasoband is also present in the diasporia TS. And also having the endodermis and pericyclic fibers. So coming to the chemical constituents. So diasporia contains the rhizomes. Rhizomes contains the starches, around 75% starches present here. And also having some bitter drugs here. And main constituent is diazoxanin. Diazoxanin is the main constituent of the diasporia. So diazoxanin is one of the steroidal saponin, saponin glycosides. And also this drug is having smilaxanin, and also epismilaxanin, and beta isomer amoxanin. So also enzyme present in the diasporia. Enzyme name is saponinase. Saponinase is enzyme present in the diasporia enzyme. Also main constituents are the diazoxanin and smilaxanin, epismilaxanin, and amoxanin. So next, coming to the uses. So uses are the, it is widely used in modern medicine. You can manufacture mainly steroids. So you can manufacture steroids from the diazoxanin. So because diazoxanin is one of the steroidal precursor, we can make different steroids from the diazoxanin. So manufacture of the estrogens, progesterones, sex hormones, oral contraceptives, and all these hormones or steroids, we can manufacture from the diazoxanin, using diazoxanin. So also this drug is useful as rheumatoid arthritis and for treatment of asthma, they're using here. And these corticosteroids like cortisone, hydrocortisone, prednisolone, and estrogens, progesterones, and testosterone, all these sex hormones, no? Will be making or will be manufacturing from using diazoxanin. So this is about diazoxanin. It's very important. So substitutes for the diasporia, floribunda is substitute, and diasporia, even composite is one of the substitute for the diazoxanin. And diazoxanin also, one more substitute is there. Costa species also substitute for the diazoxanin. So this completes diazoxanin. And coming to the identification test, like what we discussed earlier, licorice, it is also saponin glycoside, giving foam formation or maybe soap formation with water. So we can take small quantity of drug, can add water, and immediately get foam formation, soap formation. It indicates that this drug is having saponins or saponin glycosides. So next one is again same category. Another important drug is satawari. Satawari is also a very important drug. Satawari is actually dried leaves and roots obtained from the Asparagus racemosus. The source of satawari, leaves and dried roots obtained from the Asparagus racemosus, belongs to family, Liliaceae family. It is found in tropical Asian countries, Africa and Australia. So India, it is found, this drug is found in India near Himalaya region, up to 1,300 to 1,400 meters above sea level. So this is drug is cultivated, and one of the wild plant and also cultivated plant, and they will be cultivated in India, tropical Asia, and Africa and Australia. And this satawari is having some special character. This drug is having from single point, one of the climbing sharp, again this one climbing sharp. And having these leaves are having linear appearance and green in color, and leaves looks like needle like appearance, and leaves are plant BSC cladodes. Plants are having cladodes, and cladodes having the gynoecium and inflorescence you can see in the plant, And also the sleeves are the very small in size and looks like needle-like appearance, nothing but clados. Another important point is here, so Satavari is the routes, no, having from single point. So from single point, we can find number of adventurous routes, so like bunch of adventurous routes we can find from the Satavari of single point. So taking one single point, no, we can find like many adventurous routes. In this adventurous routes, so we have tubers and rootlets we can find from the from single point. Single point, it arises many adventurous routes. These routes, no, looks like the clusters. So routes looks like clusters and having a single point. From there, you can see the plenty of the adventurous routes. So we require here tuberous routes from the Satavari. So Satavari contains agonins against sterile saponins or saponin glycosides, and mainly Satavarin 1, 2, 3, 4 Satavarin. So they are the glycosides, and mainly responsible for the immunomodulatory activity. This drug is having immunomodulatory activity, and also the Satavari having quercetin, rutin, and hypersuicide also they have in Satavari, also having diazinin. Again, diazinin present in the Satavari. So Satavari is mainly used as the galactogo, so means the drugs which increase the flow of milk, and also tonic and a diuretic, and reported to produce the anti-astrogenic activity, and also one of the drug for the immunomodulatory activity which increases immune system of body. So we use this drug which can increase the immune system of body, and also for rheumatic and nerve disorders they'll be using this drug. So this completes about Satavari. So what I explained already as a galactagogue and diuretic, and as a anti-astrocytic activity, and even rheumatic disorders, nerve disorders, okay, and also immunomodulatory activity, having the immunomodulatory activity. So next drug is Shankupushpi. Is also one of the very important drug. Shankupushpi is the dried entire plant obtained from the convolvulus floricalis leaves and aerial parts, obtained from the convolvulus floricalis and convolvulus alcinoides and evolvulus alcinoides. There are three sources for the Shankupushpi: convolvulus alcinoides and evolvulus alcinoides and convolvulus floricalis. So three sources are there. So belongs to family convolvulaceae family, and so this drug is, I think you might have heard, might have seen somewhere in the medical store, Shankupushpi, Baidina Shankupushpi. One of the trade, one of the important active principles from the Shankupushpi is Shankupushpin. So Baidina company, they are extracting this drug, and they're making this one of the marketed formulation in Ayurveda. So this Shankupushpi is the leaves and aerial parts obtained from the convolvulus alcinoides, evolvulus alcinoides, convolvulus floricalis, and family is convolvulaceae family, and GS is in India, and Shankupushpi is having the attractive flowers. So flowers are pinkish in color, or violet color flowers. Are the plant bears violet color flowers and pink color flowers, and we require flowers and as well as the leaves and other aerial parts. Leaves will be green in color, and leaves will be having denser shape, and entire margin apex is acute, and flowers are they having bracts and bracteoles, and they are a purple color or pink color, violet color, the flowers, and so they have the slight odor, and they have the bitter taste, and chemical constituents. So Shankupushpi contains the glycosides and flavonoids and alkaloids, coumarins, and what I told, Shankupushpin is alkali, and very important alkali is Shankupushpin, and also they have some cetosterol, hydroxycinnamic acid, and convolvulin, and scopolamine, and octocosinol. They are all present in the Shankupushpi, flavonoids, coumarins, alkaloids, present in the Shankupushpi. So they have many uses for Shankupushpi. So what I told, increasing the memory power, mainly the Shankupushpi is used for the children. So if you take this drug, no, which increases the memory power, like brain tonic, you can use this drug as a brain tonic. So apart from the brain tonic, as a laxative, aphrodisiac, nerve tonic, regenerator, health promoting activity, and complex promoter, reduces mental tension, anti-anxiety drug, appetite, which increases hungerness, so cardio protective activity, heart strengthener, relieves sleeplessness, epilepsy, enhances memory power, coughs, preparations, asthma, and for dysuria, also mental stimulation, and tonic, brain tonic, dysentery, as a tranquilizer, insomnia, fatigue, and low energy levels. Having the anti-ulcer effect or property. So earlier we discussed the picloriza. I forgot to tell. Picloriza having the anti-hepatoprotective activity. One of the drug for liver disorders, picloriza, they'll be using as a liver disorders they'll be using, and for jaundice, and as a hepatoprotective. So protection of the hepatic liver. So nothing but the jaundice. So picloriza they'll be using as a hepatoprotective activity. I forgot to tell. So next drug is pyrethrum. So pyrethrum is again very important drug under one of the pesticide. So pyrethrum is one of the pesticides, and source is one of the flower containing drug. So pyrethrum is the dried flowers obtained from the Chrysanthemum cinerifolium, and family is Compositae family. So flowering part we'll be using here. So pyrethrum is a dried flowers obtained from the Chrysanthemum cinerifolium, and family is Compositae family. It is obtained in Japan, Brazil, Yugoslavia, India, and flower containing drug. It is cultivated in tropical areas, and as usual cultivation will be there for this drug. And flowers are the color is cream to straw color flowers, and having the characteristic odor and aromatic odor, and taste is bitter in taste, and 10 to 15 mm in diameter. These flowers are very small in size. Flowers are having the ray florets of plant receptacles they have, and they have bracts. Bracts are disc bracts. So flowers are having disc bracts, and disc florets they have, ray florets they have, and they have the bracts and bracteoles. And they have flat receptacle, and the flat receptacle covered by the many disc florets and ray florets. So this flower containing drug of the pyrethrum is having longitudinal striations, very short, and yellowish green bracts are available, and so they have the pinkish in color. The flowers are the female flowering parts. They are the pinkish in color. And they have the 23 number in each flower. They have the ray florets are having 15 to 23 number, and disc florets are nearly 200-300 disc florets we can find in the flower of the pyrethrum. Disc florets and ray florets will be there. In center we can find some flat receptacle that is covered by many disc florets and ray florets. So next, coming to the chemical constituents, as I told, pyrethrum is one of the pesticide. So pesticide means the drugs which can kill the pest. That is called as pesticide. The drugs which are killing different types of pest. Pest may be a undesirable part of the body. Maybe it's a plant body or animal body. Pest is a plant body or animal body. So pest can be killed by using pesticides. So pyrethrum is a natural pesticide. It's a very important pesticide. So under pesticides, again we have a subclassification called as insecticide. Killing insects is called as insecticide. So having insecticide a property in pyrethrum. So flowers are having the two groups of esters, and they have alcohol and acid part. Ester part will be there, alcohol part will be there, and acid part will be there. So ester part is having pyrethrin 1, and alcohol part is keto alcohol pyrethrolone. And acid part is chrysanthemum monocarboxylic acid. So we can find these three in this drug. Pyrethrin 1 is a ester part, keto alcohol pyrethrolone is alcohol part, and acid part is chrysanthemum monocarboxylic acid. So similarly, pyrethrin 2 will be there, cindrin 1 will be there, cindrin 2 will be there, jasmolin 1 will be there, jasmolin 2 will be there. So total 6 will be there: pyrethrin 1, pyrethrin 2, cindrin 1, cindrin 2, jasmolin 1, jasmolin 2, and alcohol part will be keto alcohol pyrethrolone, keto alcohol cinrolol, keto alcohol jasmolin. So acid part will be there. Acid part is a monocarboxylic acid part will be there in the this structure. So next, coming to the uses, as I said, is one of the pesticide. In the pesticide again, insecticide. So powdered drug pyrethrum is used as insecticide, killing many insects, and also strong contact poison for the insects. And as a insecticide, we'll be using this drug. This we can prepare along with the kerosene. So this powder drug we can take and we can extract with the kerosene, and we can make this pyrethrin from the powder drug of the pyrethrum. So it is used as a powder form and emulsion form, like solution or aerosol form. And we'll be using this drug to kill the many insects as insecticide. Like also this drug is having some DDT. Also useful, the sulfoxide is present in this drug. And they'll be using as a insecticide. And pyrethrum also kills the many flies and mosquitoes. So it is one of the mosquito repellent activities there for the pyrethrum. We can kill the many insects and even flies and mosquitoes. And we can have marketed formulations we have. I think Good Night and all, no? So in this, we have the pyrethrin is one of the ingredient there to prepare the Good Night and mosquito coils, mosquito repellents. No, it is one of the main ingredient. This pyrethrum is one of the main ingredient in the preparation of the different mosquito repellents and mosquito coils. So this is having a very important part. So this substitutes of the pyrethrum is chrysanthemum coccineum. For chrysanthemum coccineum is one of the substitute for the pyrethrum. So next one is another important drug is tobacco. Tobacco is a well-known drug for you people. So tobacco is the dried leaves obtained from the Nicotina tobacum and family Solanaceae family. And tobacco is cultivated in China, United States, and even in India. So India, so nearly 5 lakh metric tons tobacco we are exporting from India. So especially in Andhra Pradesh and Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Karnataka, Orissa, Bihar, all these states, they will be cultivating this tobacco. So tobacco is very small plant. So the plant is very small in size and the leaves will be very bigger in size. The plant height is 1 to 3 meters in height, and very small plant it is, and having bigger size of leaves. The leaves will be 80 centimeters length. You can imagine the leaves are very bigger in size. And flowers are the light red in color or white or pink in color. And so leaves are having a lanceolate shape or ovoid shape. And size will be 80 centimeters in length. They have very small seeds. They are brown in color. So we require here leaf portions from the tobacco. So leaves they'll be using as a, again, pesticide to kill the different pests. So tobacco also, again, one of the important drug. And this tobacco, they'll be using as a CNS stimulant. So because they contains the nicotine is the main constituent, is alkaloids present in the tobacco. So alkaloids are the, pyridine and pyridine alkaloids are present in the this tobacco. So in this main constituent is nicotine, and also non-nicotine is there, and anabasin. Nicotine, non-nicotine, anabasin, they are the three important constituents of the tobacco. And this tobacco, they'll be using making cigarettes, they'll be using the tobacco. And nicotine is the main principle there. And tobacco, nicotine using as an insecticide since many centuries. And nicotine controls the having insecticide property. And also as a CNS stimulant. Tobacco is actually central nervous system stimulant because nicotine is there. Nicotine is useful as a CNS stimulant and also as a pesticide. As a pesticide, as a insecticide and a CNS stimulant, and making cigarettes from the tobacco. And so from the from tobacco, I think from India, I see they're getting large production from the tobacco. and they are getting a good amount of money from the tobacco. So this completes the miscellaneous drugs. So drugs acting on CNS, I left some drugs under CNS. So one is Belladonna. So I think I have completed Dhatur earlier. So Belladonna, I have not completed Belladonna. So Belladonna is leaves and other aerial parts obtained from the atrope of Belladonna, belongs to family Solanaceae. So Belladonna actually one of the important drug. So Belladonna, bell means beautiful, donna means lady. So meaning is bell means beautiful, donna means lady. So beautiful lady. So the plant is very attractive. So looks very attractive. That's why they compare with the beautiful lady, this Belladonna. And here we require the leaves and other aerial parts of the plant. Atropa Belladonna, Solanaceae family. GS is India, England and European countries. And India, they are found in the Himalaya region. So this, if you go for the history behind the Belladonna, so they're using those days this drug for the hallucinogenic drug. And as for the witchcraft in Middle Ages, so they'll be doing some Mata Mantra and all. So witchcraft, as a witchcraft, they'll be using this drug those days. And later, this juice of the plant were using for a cosmetic area. So because of this, because dilation of the pupil in the eyes, no? It dilates the pupil in the eyes. So those days, they'll be using this drug for the, as a cosmetic. And juice of the plant is using as a cosmetic those days. But now we are using as a, for dilation of the pupil. So leaves will be brown to green in color, and flowers purple to yellow color, fruits green to brown in color, and water slight and characteristic, taste bitter and acrid. So leaves 5 to 25 centimeters length, and they have flowers. Flowers are having corolla, fruits are having 10 centimeter diameter. So leaves ovate shape, lanceolate shape, broadly ovate. And so since it is a leaf containing drug, we can find the epidermis, upper epidermis, lower epidermis, trichomes will be there, stomata will be there, parasite will be there, crystals will be there in the drug. So coming to constituents, Belladonna contains tropane alkaloids. So tropane alkaloids contains mainly atropine, iosamine, and iosine. It's very important here, we have three plants. One is Dhatura, second Belladonna, third is hyoscyamus. So these three plants are having same family. Same family means Solanaceae family and same constituents. So these three plants are having same constituents and same family. It is very significant character under chemotaxonomy. Under chemotaxonomy, very significant. It is having same family and same chemical constituents. So they have some tropane alkaloids, atropine, iosamine, iosine, and all these three drugs belongs to Solanaceae family. So uses as a parasympatholytic and what I told medriatic. So medriatic means the drugs which dilates a pupil is called as medriatic. So opposite is myotic. So myotic means contraction of the pupil. So here dilation of pupil is different and contraction of pupil is different. So medriatic means dilation of pupil in the eyes and also having parasympatholytic activity, antispasmodic, sedative and hypnotic, and as a local anesthetic, as a painkiller. This drug also useful as a painkiller. And substitutes are Solanum nigrum and Ailanthus glandulosa are the two substitutes from this drug. So coming to the chemical test. So this drug is having very important chemical test. The test name is Vitellimorin test. Is Vitellimorin test very important test for the this Belladonna. So we have to take the drug and we have to treat with the drug. Is drug we have to take, the test solution we have to prepare, and test solution. So we have to treat with the fuming nitric acid, and you have to go for the heating and boiling for some time. After boiling, you have to go for evaporation. After evaporation, it should dryness, it should dry. After dryness, no, you have to add the methanolic potassium hydroxide solution to an acetone solution. So you have to add the methanolic potassium hydroxide to the acetone solution of the nitrate residue. So because we are adding nitric acid to the nitrate residue, you have to add acetone and methanolic potassium hydroxide. It gives violet color formation. It is very important test. The test name is Vitellimorin test. So Vitellimorin test answers the all these three alkaloids. Belladonna and Datura and Iosamis. All these three drugs answers the white limonene test because of this three drugs that I have in tropane alkaloids, atropine, iosamine and iosine. So next drug is Iosamis, is also same category. Iosamis is dry leaves and chlorine tops obtained from the Iosamis niger, and family is Solanaceae family. And again, it is also European countries in India and even Western Asia, they'll be cultivating this drug. Again, it's one of the very important drug for the, as per literature, so these drugs they'll be using for the, as per literature, this drug is using for the, like what I explained earlier, that Belladonna, same. So this drug also they'll be using for the, treating the, like eye diseases. So since it is a leaf drug, so you can find the epidermis and parasite and even stomata will be there, and calcium oxalate crystals will be there, and trichomes will be there, and phloem xylem will be there. So all these things will be there in the leaf drugs. So those things present in the this Iosamis, and chemical constituents, same constituents, tropane alkaloids, atropine, iosamine and iosine are the three main constituents of the Iosamis. It is also useful as antispasmodic and anti-asthmatic and sedative and hypnotic and as purgative. And substitutes is Egyptian embane is another substitute for the Iosamis. And chemical test is same chemical test. White limonene test also answers this Iosamis. So I told mydriatic, same property, antispasmodic, anti muscarinic, anti salago, means the drugs which restricts the flow of the excess saliva, sedative and cough, so asthma and anthelmintic, stomachache and anti-inflammatory. So this completes the this Iosamis. So one more drug is aconite. So aconite is again one of the poisonous drug, highly poisonous drug is aconite, is highly poisonous drug. So synonym is aconitum, and it is a dried tuberous roots obtained from the aconitum lapillus, and family is Ranunculaceae family. And so this is a highly poisonous drug. It is cultivated in Hungary, Germany and Spain, Switzerland, in India. So the roots are the conical appearance, roots looks like radish, so looks like carrot, roots looks like radish and carrot, but carrot and radish are smooth appearance, soft, but this root is very hard. The roots are having daughter roots and main roots, so main roots and daughter roots are present in this aconite root. Roots are conical appearance, they are dark brown in color and very slight odor. The taste is highly poisonous taste, a bitter in taste. If you chew this drug, I think we'll get tingling sensation followed by numbness. Of course, we can't chew this drug since we're having poisonous principles. We can't chew, we can't use this orally, this drug. And size will be 4 to 10 centimeters length and 1 to 3.5 centimeters weight. So roots are very broad and looks like the carrot or radish. And the top of the root is having crown, and lower side is a tapering lower side like radish, like carrot. And it's very hard in nature and the conical appearance. The root is having conical appearance, very hard and having daughter roots. And so dark brown in color. So they have some wrinkles inside the root, and rootlets also present inside the root. And coming to the chemical constituents, so aconite contains the diterpene alkaloids, so mainly aconine and aconitine. Aconitine on hydrolysis will get the benzyl aconine and acetic acid. Benzyl aconine again hydrolysis will get the aconine and benzyl acid. First aconitine hydrolysis, benzyl aconine and acetic acid. Benzyl aconine again hydrolysis will get the aconine and benzyl acid. So aconine and aconitine are the important constituents of the aconite. So both are the diterpene alkaloids, highly poisonous drug, and that's why this drug will be using externally, not internally. This drug we can't use internally. So externally in the form of liniment. So we can prepare liniment And we can use this drug for the treatment of rheumatism or joint pains or neuralgia. For the joint pain, as a painkiller, we can apply for the joints, for legs, and as I said, rheumatic pain, rheumatic disease, and inflammation as anti-inflammatory, and use of neuralgia, and cardiac depressant, not cardiac stimulant, is one of the cardiac depressant. And of course, we can't use this drug in Ayurveda, but we can use this drug externally, not internally. But of course, they'll be using this drug in homeopathy. Homeopathy treatment, this drug they'll be using, but in Ayurveda, we'll be using this drug. We can making liniments and lotions, we're applying externally to the legs and joints to reduce the pain, Also as an anti-inflammatory, means no, the drugs which reduce the inflammation in the body is called as anti-inflammatory. So this completes the, I think, two drugs under CNS stimulants, drugs acting as CNS. One is Avicennia and the other one is Bredona. Aconite, again, there is a separate category, aconite. That also we completed now. And I completed the miscellaneous drugs. So last, I left one more drug under carminatives. So carminatives, what is carminative? So carminatives are the drugs which can relieve the excess gases present in the stomach, or expel the gases in the stomach, is called as the carminative. So in this category, we have the one drug. The drug name is Nutmeg. Nutmeg is, fruits are available. The fruits are very hard. So they are looks like rounded appearance, these fruits. And source is Nutmeg. Jaipal is a synonym. Jaipal, Jajikaya, Jaipal. So source is dried fruits obtained from the fruits and the kernels and seeds obtained from Myristica fragrans. And family is Myristicaceae family. And GS is India. So these fruits are very rough, very hard, and looks like the rounded appearance, a subglobose appearance, a subspherical appearance, and they are the reddish brown in color, these fruits, or yellowish brown in color, these fruits, and very hard in nature. The fruits are having the pericarp, mesocarp, endocarp. So these parts are there in the fruits, and so they are the around 5 to 8 centimeters in diameter, and these fruits, and they are the aromatic odor, and taste is again aromatic. And this contains volatile ice. Nutmeg contains volatile ice. So 15% volatile ice are present, and fats are present here, 30 to 40%. Also contains phytosterols, starch is there, aminodextrin, and coloring matter, and saponin is present in the drug. So mainly volatile ice are present here. Volatile ice contains myristicin. So Myristica fragrans is source of the drug, and Myristicaceae is family. So constituents are the myristicin is present in the Myristica fragrans or Nutmeg. So this Nutmeg can be used as a Nutmeg. We can make the oil from Nutmeg. So that oil can be prepared by a steam distillation method, other methods, and this can be used as stimulant, a flavoring agent, and carminative. Carminative, stimulant, and flavoring agents. And so oil prepared by using Nutmeg that can be used as a chronic rheumatism. You can apply this oil for the rheumatic pains. Again, you can apply this oil for the rheumatic pains externally, so that you can reduce the pain in the legs or joints by using this drug. So one of this drug is actually substitutes will be basswood is there. One basswood is there. That basswood, no, I think what they will do, the basswood, they will cut and shape this basswood, looks like Nutmeg fruit. And this basswood, they can mix sometimes in place of Nutmeg. So we cannot find out easily. So basswood is a wood containing drug. They properly cut and shape the round shape. And this basswood, no, sometimes they can mix in place of Nutmeg. So we cannot be able to find out which is basswood, which is Nutmeg. So like that, they will do adulteration in the, generally they will do adulteration to get the profits in the market. So this is one of the adulterant of the Nutmeg is basswood. Basswood is an adulterant of the Nutmeg. So this completes your carminative drugs. I think only one drug I left. And today we have completed the miscellaneous drugs. So we have completed the CNS stimulants. We have completed the aconite. another category, that is, and we also completed the one commemorative, that is that mark. So this completes today's portion. Thank you.